Hi there, ladies and gentlemen. It's me, Dr. Donna. Time for week 2852. Check out what I have for you. Last week's book was Freakonomics, A Rogue Economist Explores the Hidden Side of Everything. Ladies and gentlemen, can I tell you that I was excited about reading this book? And then I read the book. And here's what I have to say about Freakonomics. That's right, Freakonomics. It's supposed to be a book, and notice I said supposed. And ladies and gentlemen, you know I don't like the word supposed. But this book is supposed to be about a person, an economist, who is rogue, who has the ability to ask questions that no one has ever even thought about asking, and then doing the research, taking the numbers and the data, making it all come together in a way that just makes us go, oh my God. That was supposed to occur in this book. For me, it fell flat. Now we know I have a past that would make anyone go, oh my God, how are you standing up straight? Perhaps I'm not the person that should have read this book, but I did in fact read this book and I'm not a fan of it. I didn't find that any of the information was something that I went, oh my goodness, wow, I didn't know that. How did you put those two together? It's like a person who has a restaurant and they put food that doesn't belong together, so you think you're going to have this exotic meal and you end up just having something that's like, eh, I could take it or leave it. That's how I felt about Freakonomics. Wasn't anything freaky for me, taking two things that could be diametrically opposed and put them together so that you could go, wow, I would have never thought that when you put these two together, you end up with this end result. It fell flat for me, like I said before, nothing freaky deaky about it. Don't waste your time. There wasn't anything extraordinary about it. Was it better than most boring economists? Sure. But all you have to do to be better than any boring economist is add a little splash of paint. Just put a little lemon juice in it, and you're going to be more exciting than those boring duds. But was it freakish? Absolutely not. Thumbs down for me. Go on to the next book. You don't have to waste your time, ladies and gentlemen. I have done it for you. Move on, move on, move on, move on, move on. Seriously, ladies and gentlemen, thumbs down for me. Nothing freakish about it at all. What book do we have this week? 9 Things a Leader Must Do. As you know, my doctorate is in organizational leadership, and I'm always looking to see what my peers in the industry have to say. Let's see if I'll get some new tools in the toolkit. Well, that's my time this week, ladies and gentlemen. But before I get out of here, just remember, if it's possible for me, then it's possible for you. Watch what we do in 52. I'll see you guys next week. Adios.